because I understand that you're on a mission. You have to go to Jacksonville. But I am going to let the Lord use me for His glory, not for mine, but for His glory. The scripture had already been read, but I'm going to go back to my scripture. 1 Corinthians, the 6th chapter, and the 20th verse. For you are bought with a price, therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are the Lord.
That's right.
And come on and go to 1 Peter. First chapter, the 18th and the 19th verse. For as much as ye know that ye were not redeemed with corruptible things, as silver and gold, for your vain conversation received by traditions from your father. But, come on somebody, say but. With the precious blood of Christ.
Amen, amen.
As of a lamb without blemish and without spot.
Amen.
Is that all right?
Amen.
It's the word of God, because I read it straight from the Holy Word.
Amen.
Of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let us pray. Our Father, our Lord, and our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, we just want to pause right now and tell you thank you again. Father, we told you thank you this morning during Sunday school. We told you thank you when we rose this morning.
Yes.
Father, we told you thank you at the beginning of the service. But Father, we want to tell you thank you again. Thank you for being so good to us. Because this moment right here was not promised to us. But because of your grace and your glory, hallelujah, Lord, for you loving us so much, you spared these few minutes again for us. And we just want to tell you thank you. Now, Heavenly Father, as I begin to give your word, Father, I ask that you just go ahead and hide me on behind the cross. For I know that without the cross, hallelujah, I would be no good. Without Jesus, the one that bled and died for me on that cross, Lord, I would be no good. So, Father, I just want to tell you thank you right now. Thank you for being so good to us. All through the week, you kept us, dear God. You let no hurt, harm, nor danger come upon us.
Yes.
And Father God, as some of us went over dangerous highways, dear God, you kept us.
Yes.
You kept us safe, Father, as we were out there fighting the deers and the leftover drunks and the animals and things that's running in front of us.
Yes.
But Father God, you kept us, and you didn't let no hurt, harm, or danger come to us. Lord, thank you for being so good to us. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Christ Jesus' precious name I do pray.
Yeah.
Amen.
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 And amen.
Amen.
I guess you're wondering why I went down and put some popcorn and an envelope on the table. Well, my message this morning is coming from those items there. My subject is salvation. It's not a game.
All right.
So what games are you playing?
All right.
I know all of you are familiar with the game shows that comes on TV.
Uh-huh.
Just to name a few, The Price is Right.
Yes.
Truth or Consequences.
All right.
Deal or No Deal.
Uh-huh.
Just some of the games. Truth or Dare. But so this morning, I need anyone that would like to volunteer. Amen. Come on up. Now we know that The Price is Right. You have to bid on an item. And you have to come as close to the price of that item without going over.
All right, all right.
You can't go over. If you go over, you can't get it. But as long as you come as close to it, I mean, you can do a dollar, whatever.
Go ahead now.
So, Gina, go ahead and bid what you want to say. That box of popcorn is, let me come down here. I can't tell you that. This is Axe 2, buttery kettle corn, 0 trans fat, and it's 3 packs. in this box. So Regina is going to bid on this box of popcorn without going over. And I will tell you, it did not come from the dollar store.
Okay. Was it Walmart?
You gotta
move.
$3. Okay, well, Regina, you went over. Someone else.
$175.
Come on. Jenny, you may be seated. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Just the popcorn, now, just the popcorn. You went over. You may be seated. Oh, you can only go one time. Come on, Zion. Zion, the popcorn is yours. Okay, that was The Price is Right. Now, Zion, I want to let's make a deal. Are you willing to trade that box of popcorn for what's in this envelope? You want to trade it?
It's up to you.
Okay, it's up to you.
Worth it.
Zion, go ahead and tell him what's in the pop, what's in the envelope. She got a zonk. She got a zonk. And that's what we're going to talk about this morning is making a deal, truth or consequences, truth or dare, and the price is right. Hallelujah. Now I'm going to start talking about truth or consequences right now. Truth or consequences started back in Genesis.
Go ahead now.
When God told Adam, because he did tell Adam, he didn't tell Eve, that he may eat from any tree in that garden, but one.
That's right.
Yes, he did.
That's right.
But along came Satan.
All right.
And Satan told Eve, I got to go ahead and get through with this because I'm on a time frame. So y'all just bear with me.
Go ahead.
Satan told Eve, oh, come on now, Eve. Let's play a game. Truth. He just said truth.
All right.
He didn't give her the consequences. He didn't give her the consequences. He told her that God said that you could. No, come on. You can eat.
Uh-huh.
Because, see, God with the big G know that if you ate from the tree that you're not supposed to eat from, you're going to be like the gods.
Uh-huh.
The little G with the S on the end.
Go ahead.
And Eve, not thinking about the consequences
say so.
That was going to come after she ate that piece of fruit. She gave it to her husband to eat. She didn't think about the consequences because that's the way Satan do.
That's right.
Satan will give you a little bit of the truth, but he will not give you the consequences that you got to go through after. Is that all right?
That's all right.
Yes, it is. It's all right.
That's good preaching.
Now I'm going back now to truth or dare. I'm going to go to the book of Job. I went through the Bible. I wanted to go through all my prophets, but like I said, I'm on a time limit.
Go ahead and preach
them. See, the book of Job contains 288 questions.
Yeah.
And more than a third of them questions was asked by God.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Okay?
That's right.
But God's first two questions in the book of Job was to whom? Uh-huh. Satan.
That's right.
He said, where are you coming from?
Uh-huh.
Satan wasn't invited to the meeting.
Mm-hmm.
But I guess he thought like some of us used to do it when we was out there in the world, we're gonna crash that party. So Satan decided to come along also.
Yes, he did.
And the next question that God asked Satan was, have you considered my servant Job? Hallelujah. He told Satan, he said, look, Job is an upright man.
Yes.
There's no one like him on earth.
Uh-huh.
He is blameless and upright.
That's right.
A man who fears God and shun evil. Now I want you to notice that God is the first one to bring up Job's name.
All right.
Satan didn't bring Job's name, but God brought him up. Yes, he did. And apparently, God knew something that Satan didn't know.
Yes, right. Well, take your time.
Preach, woman of God.
Take your time. Mm-hmm.
God knew all about Job.
Yeah.
You see, God don't gamble.
Well,
Satan gambled.
Uh-huh.
God don't gamble.
All right.
But he invests.
Yes,
yes, he do.
That's good. That's good.
And within 24 hours after God and Satan had this conversation, Job had then lost everything.
Uh-huh.
He lost his wife.
Mm-hmm.
He lost his children.
Uh-huh.
He lost his cattle.
Yes.
He lost his camel.
Yes.
He lost his truck. He lost his car. He lost his house. He lost everything.
Yes, he did.
But there was one thing that Job did not lose.
Right.
Yeah.
Say so.
One thing.
That's right.
That Job didn't lose. He didn't lose his trust in God.
That's right. That's right.
How did God know that Job wasn't going to lose his trust in him?
Well.
Apparently, now, God had already used Job.
Well.
He already knew that Job would stand the test.
Uh-huh.
Yes, he did. Apparently, sometime in Job's life, God had taken him for a few trials, and Job succeeded.
Uh-huh.
God don't test us to break us.
Well,
come on.
He tests us to determine the strength of our character and the depth of our integrity.
Yes,
yes, he
good.
Did. So it was truth or dare.
Yes, sir.
The devil dared God that if you just take your hands off of Job, if you just take the hedge from around him, that Job would curse you to your face. That's what the Satan told God. So that was a part of truth and dare. And Job passed the test of truth. Is that all right? Let's go on up to this next game. Deal or no deal? From the beginning of their existence, the Israelites were told they had a choice to obey or disobey. God said one would be rewarded and the other would carry serious consequences.
That's right.
See, he said, I'm setting before you this day a blessing and a curse.
That's right.
The blessing if you obey the commandment of the Lord your God.
Mm-hmm.
The curse if you disobey the command of the Lord your God.
Uh-huh.
Unfortunately, they disobeyed.
My Lord.
When Satan came to him, he said, deal. Oh, no deal.
All right.
They took the deal of Satan.
All right.
Instead of the deal of God.
Lord have mercy.
Is that all right?
It's all right.
Now I'm going to come on back to my price is right.
All right. Now. Go ahead now.
All down through from Genesis on down to Revelation.
Yeah.
God spoke to the prophets. Mm-hmm. He spoke to priests.
Well,
he spoke to judges.
Uh-huh.
He even spoke to ordinary people.
Yeah.
And he let them know
there's
a price to pay
right.
for salvation.
That's right.
And Zion, the price couldn't be almost, which you were almost close. You didn't get it right on the heat, but you were close. The price couldn't be maybe. The price had to be exact, Pastor. It had to be exact. It had to be the exact price. And the exact price of salvation for you and me was the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Him hanging on a cross. It couldn't be with an almost. It had to be exact. God said he needed someone to go.
Take your time.
And his precious son, who was God himself.
Yes, sir.
But he became flesh.
Yes, he did.
He was born as a baby, just like you and I.
Yeah.
He said, I will go down and I will redeem mankind. I will shed my precious blood up on an old rugged cross. And that is just what he did. He hung there on that cross. They pierced him in the side. That's what we got to tell Satan now. because he's going to tempt you.
Yes,
don't think that you are so saved that he will not try to tempt you. Pastor, he will try to tempt you. He will try to tempt me. He will try to tempt every one of you out there. You got to know which game he's playing. You got to know if the price is right. You got to know if it's let's make a deal. You got to know if it's deal or no deal. You got to know if it's true or dare. And then some more games the Hollywood Square, where we think that we are so, you know, we got it all going on. And we can sit up in that square and we can get the X or the O's. You got to know which game Satan is playing with you. And when he do come to you, because it's not that he's not going to come. He's coming.
He's coming.
And when he come, make sure you let him know. Deal or no deal. Tell him no deal.
No deal.
Tell him the price has already been paid. And the price was right. Let him know about the truth or the consequences. Let him know that if I do this, I got to pay the consequences too. Our mother Eve and our father Adam, they didn't think about the consequences that was coming afterwards. But we've got to think about the consequences. We got to think about the consequences. Because they will come. And the consequences are not pretty, y'all. They're not. They're not. Let Satan know you're not playing his games. No more.
That's right.
It's all right.
That's all right.
No more.
That's right.
Truth of consequences. The price is right.
Yes, sir.
Deal or no deal. Truth or dare. Which game are you willing to play?
Amen.
Amen.